Taking a minute to get up here because we just had a new severe thunderstorm warning that was issued for our area. So let's go ahead and show you all the polygons that are in effect at this time, because we are tracking a line of storms still capable of producing winds at 60 miles per hour and a lot of lightning associated with this cluster of thunderstorms traveling over Shelby County as we speak. And this is getting ready to move into Rush County, where we now have that new severe thunderstorm warning. But we still have the severe thunderstorm warning in effect for Johnson and Shelby County. That's going to last until 12:45 p.m. along with another severe thunderstorm warning for Decatur, Hancock, Rush, and Shelby County. That too will last until 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and it's because of this line of storms traveling over Shelby County. This is moving to the east northeast, right around 55 miles per hour. Based on when I turn on the wind velocity, the strongest winds at this time near Morristown, right over Shelbyville, and right along I-74 through the central part of Shelby County. And then we also have a cluster of strong winds east of Hendricks, and again traveling to the east right around 55 miles per hour and capable of producing wind gusts at 60 miles per hour. We haven't had any thunderstorm activity or rainfall in our southeastern counties, and that's why the storm that we are tracking is holding its strength as it does travel in that northeasterly direction. We're not in the clear just yet because there's another round of thunderstorms that will arrive by the time we head into the afternoon hours. This too producing severe thunderstorm warnings as it travels over northeast Missouri or southeast Missouri and then moving into western parts of Illinois. We have some broken cloud cover that is across central Illinois, and if that continues with those trends, the atmosphere is going to warm up and charge up again, and it will produce some strong severe thunderstorms once again. But we have a slight risk for severe weather that is highlighted across the state, and that is a level 2 of 5, but also an enhanced risk of level 3. That just means an elevated threat for severe weather, looking more favorable in the atmosphere closer to Rushville, Richmond, Bloomington, and Columbus. Any storm that fires up today through the afternoon, producing damaging winds and then also a hail threat. I do want to show you future cast, walking you through the next several hours. 1 o'clock, still having some showers and storms around. More storms arriving for the afternoon. When I stop future cast at 6 p.m., most of the thunderstorm activity is concentrated across the southern half of the area. We still have a chance for some storms in the northern part of the state. However, it's just more concentrated for areas south of I-70, and that's why it's so important to stay weather aware through the afternoon and evening hours. 70 is the temperature now. Southwest wind 15 miles per hour. We do have temperatures in the 70s at this time. Should rise near 79. That'll be early on in the afternoon, and then we have that chance for thunderstorms that'll last until the evening hour. So we'll go ahead and jump into our 7-day forecast, falling to 55 tonight under a partly cloudy sky, 67 for Wednesday, another chance for scattered rainfall for Wednesday afternoon, 73 Thursday, and then on Friday we will have temperatures rising near 66 degrees with a spotty shower chance. By Saturday, an early shower, and that's very early in the morning, likely not going to have major impacts to the mini marathon because we're still tracking a lot of dry time on Saturday. Sunday 66, brighter with more sunshine from Monday. Melissa.
Thanks, Amber.